Malcolm, have you got the latest tidal readings from Wick?
We lost the signal from the monitoring station.
What was the last reading before we lost the signal?
What?
That's got to be a mistake.
Dad's really been looking forward to having you over. Yes, he has. I am not patronizing you. Mel? Mel? She hung up on me. Please tell me I was never like that.
Orty, please.
Preferably with a sedative.
How about with a biscuit instead?
There's water pouring through the door.
Hurry up then.
You need to review this. Pressure's continuing to drop in the North Sea.
Our press officers are pushing for further updates. We're inundated with requests.
I need to run the latest shipping forecast.
Right. Okay. Quiet, everyone. This storm we've been tracking the last few days, I need everything on it. Where it's headed, how fast? Get me the latest atmospheric pressure reports for the northeast.
Yes, sir.
And everything you've got from the British Oceanic Data Centre. In 40 minutes, I'm briefing the Deputy Prime Minister.
And the
is across the river and is capable of holding back billions of gallons of water that would otherwise flood London. The barrier is what lets us keep safe at night.
Morning.
Samantha Morrison.
You're clear.
Miss Morrison, these came for you.
Thank you.
Morning, Frank.
Boss.
See the news?
If you're referring to the football, I don't want to talk about it.
I'm not.
This will be what you're interested in, then. Figures for the tidal gauge is Murray, Aberdeen. Things aren't looking too clever with this storm in Scotland.
To high tide. Can you recalculate the tide's expected height when it reaches London Bridge? I'll activate the normal protocol for a high tide closure.
No problem.
The rescue operation continues here in Wick, despite continuing hazardous conditions. Air rescue support has been called in, but those in need of rescue far outnumber available resources, leaving many stranded on rooftops and high ground.
Figures from Wick show the current death toll at 21. Another 15 are missing. We can expect those numbers to rise. We're still waiting for reports from further along the coast.
And the Prime Minister is calling in from Australia in about 10 minutes. So I need a damn good explanation of why we had no warning.
Sir?
Isn't this the same storm that hit the east coast of the United States?
Sir. Forecasting is not an exact science.
Haven't you been tracking it across the Atlantic for the past 5 days?
The storm is constantly changing.
You have models, don't you?
With respect, sir, when a storm surge is moving this fast, there's no scientific means of predicting exactly what it's going to do. By the time we have new data, it's already out of date.
But what's going to happen next?
Well, based on the available data, the storm is moving northeast back into the North Sea.
So the worst of it's over?
I believe so.
Though actually, you can't predict what this storm is going to do at all, can you?
I'm confident about this, sir.
Deploy full emergency services within a 50-mile radius of Wick and use all available resources to check the sea defences below Wick.
Already underway.
Right, let's try and do everything we can and hope this time you might be right.
Calling to remind you it's your granddaughter's christening at 10 o'clock.
Oh, I haven't forgotten.
Please don't be late. And, Dad, just so you know, Rob's coming.
I see.
Yeah, I didn't think he'd be able to make it, but...
Yes, it's been a long time. Are you sure this is a good idea?
Yes, I do.
Does Rob know I'd be there?
Dad, I want you there, and your granddaughter wants you there. It's a big day for her, you know. So no excuses, please.
10 o'clock, then.
Don't be late.
How are you holding up?
Well, we're used to turbulent weather here in Scotland. But this was something else. We just were not prepared. Why weren't we given any warning?
Sir, do you have any idea of the fatalities we've experienced today? Sir?
No.
Any advice for us?
What's your name? What's her name?
Her name is Kirsty.
Kirsty? That's a very pretty name. Very pretty name.
Why wasn't I talking about opera? Set up a meeting with Hopkins from the Met Office and Fuller from the Environment Agency. And they better damn well have an explanation.
Hey, Kate.
Yeah, look. Of all the help you need.
Just in time.
I gotta go, bye. Minute to spare.
You didn't have to come back for this, you know.
What kind of uncle did you take me for?
Thank you.
Waiting on someone?
It's probably just as well.
We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water to sustain, refresh, and cleanse all life. Over water, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through water, you led the children of Israel from slavery in Egypt to freedom in the Promised Land, received the baptism of John, and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. What name have you given this child?
Elsa.
And know your goodness all her days, and be protected from evil. Elsa Amelia. And of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hey.
Okay. Why didn't you tell me you'd be here?
Because I knew you'd react like this. And I wanted you both here. We've hardly seen each other since Mum died.
Oh, yeah, maybe you're right. Maybe you're right. He did turn up for the funeral, I'll give you that.
My daughter needs a grandfather. She deserves that. Rob, this is a new start. I'd like us to look forwards.
Wait.
Be a family.
Wait. Yeah, wait. Family. What, you mean like being there when the kids are growing up, that kind of thing?
Oh, come on, you know it wasn't as simple as that. You should see him with us. He really does care.
The only thing he cares about is himself. Anna.
You okay?
Yeah, bad day.
Well, it's about to get worse. You need to go to the barrier.
What?
They're closing the gates this evening. But there's a problem, and it needs looking at right away.
Thank you.
Rob.
You're the only one I have left.
Yeah, Christ, I mean, Sam's there.
We're under contract. Someone's got to check it out.
Well, that's easy for you, this though. You weren't married to the woman. There must be someone else. What about you?
Very funny, but I'm a bit busy running your business for you. Taxi's on its way. Bye.
Yeah, thanks.
More coverage from Aunt Bruce.
Oh, thanks.
And Inspector Hendricks' mum has sent you in some cakes again.
Why don't you just take them home?
I don't think it's me. She's trying to fatten up, Mom. Penny? Penny? Can you get me Samantha Morrison at the barrier?
Will do.
Severe storm that devastated Wick and Arbroath earlier today is continuing to wreak havoc further south, having left a trail of carnage in Scotland. The storm is now battering the coastal towns of northern England.
Hello?
Malcolm?
Leonard Morrison.
Professor Morrison.
Been a long time.
Indeed.
I have a favour to ask you. Now's not really a good time, Professor. The boss is on the warpath and we're flat out dealing with this storm.
This won't take a minute. Could you email me the figures from all the tide gauges?
South of Aberdeen.
Can I ask
why you need that information?
Let's call it
professional curiosity. We can call it that. I wouldn't ask for these figures if I didn't need them.
These storms continue to wreak havoc here in the northeast. Winds of up to 9
Just hold for a moment. The chairman of the US Federal Bank. Mr. Moyes, you're on speakerphone.
Arthur.
I'm sorry to hear about your casualties.
Well, no, I appreciate that, Arthur, and I'll convey your sentiments to the Prime Minister.
I'm sure you're aware the dollar has dropped a further 40 points overnight. Confidence has been lower here since the storm damage in Maine. And we have some big players dumping some huge quantities of stock. We could be facing a major meltdown.
But I'm sorry to hear that, Arthur, but, you know, just at this moment we're trying to deal with the human catastrophe.
I'm just calling to let you know you could be facing an economic one, too.
A couple of these guys have started dumping UK stock. It's having a ripple effect. Thanks, Arthur. Talk to you later.
Yeah, absolutely, ma'am. As you know, due to the high spring tide and the storm damage in Scotland, we are planning a precautionary closure. But if anything comes up, I will certainly let you know.
Thanks. Penny, get me the Met office.
Will do.
I assure you, Commissioner, you have the full cooperation of the Met office on this.
I need to be kept fully informed.
I've emailed you the latest updates.
Thank you. Thanks for your cooperation.
Yeah, we're on top of everything.
Professor, I'm a bit busy, actually.
Hear me out. Those figures you sent me for the tide gauges.
Yeah?
Don't you think they're on the high side?
It's a storm surge.
Nothing to be unexpected, given the circumstances.
I fed the numbers into my computer model.
If the surge continues to grow at this rate,
the entire east coast of England could be in trouble.
Malcolm. The latest on the tidal gauges.
Better go.
All right. Thanks, Anna. Hi, Sam.
What are you doing here?
Problem in Pier 1. No one else available.
Right. Well, it'll do you good to get your hands dirty.
You're looking well.
Thanks. Your business is good? Anna still running things for you?
Well, nothing's changed. She gives the orders. I obey. Nice flowers.
I know it's not your birthday.
Well, I know. It's great, isn't it?
Yeah, it's great. Does he know you hate roses?
Oh, look at this. Must be my lucky day. They sent the big boss for me to push around. Oh, you're all.
You're looking lovely, Zabba Frank.
Well, shall we go?
Our guys don't think it's anything major, but with this early closure and seeing as how we pay you guys so much just to sit around, I thought I might call on your services.
What do you reckon?
Could be corrosion or wear problem in the main bearings.
Which would affect lift capacity. Yeah, we thought as much.
Leave it with me. I'll run some ultrasonic tests if it turns up positive.
We wait 9 months for the parts to arrive.
Frank, I'm in. It's Pete down on Pier 3. There's a hydraulic problem I need you to look at.
On my way. Sorry.
All right.
Stall body count rises. Stall body count rises. Place standard.
I want to know we're not going to need any more body bags before this day's out.
Latest figures have the storm heading east into the North Sea, towards the Hook of Holland.
That's what you told me this morning. What about Arbroath?
Sir, with all due respect, this storm is not behaving within expected parameters.
Has the danger passed, yes or no?
It's difficult to say. If the prevailing wind were to drive the storm south, the surge would be squeezed between the British coastline and mainland Europe. Now, this creates a funneling effect and raises sea level.
But that's just a worst-case scenario. Most surges lose momentum before that. They just peter out.
Not always, though.
No, not always.
So, what do you think?
Well, nothing of immediate concern.
She's pretty tough.
Yeah.
How much longer do you need?
It's your deadline for closure.
Well, we need you out of here in 2.5 hours.
Oh, well. In that case,
I'll get out of your way as soon as possible then, shall I?
You know I didn't mean it like that.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Well, you can manage till Frank gets back.
Oh, yeah, don't worry about me.
His name is Duncan. We've been out a few times. I don't need to explain myself to you.
Yeah, that's right. So why are you?
Because you asked.
No, I didn't.
So you wanted to know. He's an architect.
Oh, really?
England are 2-0 up. 2-0. Oh, you're Canadian. Why would you care?
Is it possible that this storm could change its course?
If we did see the storm change its current course and a severe rise in sea level, there could be extensive flooding down the east coast of England.
Damage estimate?
Well, the last time we saw something similar was 1953. The storm that hit East Anglia and Canvey Island killed 300 people on land and another 200 at sea, nearly. That surge was a body of water 4 meters high, the size of Ireland. At present, we know that this storm is heading out to sea. Experience suggests it would be pointless to cause further and unnecessary alarm at this stage.
Right. So tell me, how the hell am I going to reassure the public?
Thank you, sir. Does the Prime Minister have any plans to cancel this tour of the Commonwealth, return home here to deal with this crisis?
Well, the situation is fully under control, of course, but yes, the Prime Minister will be flying home from Sydney because, well, he's very keen to be here for and with the British public at this time. Yes.
Why was there no warning?
Well, you know, just at this present time, we're concentrating on managing the situation. The latest figures from the Met Office indicate that the storm is heading eastwards out into the North Sea.
Deputy Prime Minister, are you saying that the danger has passed?
Well, yes, yes. I'm very pleased to be able to say that the indicators at the present time
show that our coastline is no longer under threat. And that's the last question. Thank you.
There's a gentleman in reception. I explained you were busy, but he won't take no for an answer. He's insisting on seeing you.
Who?
He says his name's Leonard Morrison.
It's okay, he's fine.
Sorry to have to trouble you.
No, it's fine. We'll talk in my office.
But tonight's high tide is the highest tide of the year.
Which is why we are closing the barrier.
My computer model is now predicting that the storm and the surge will reach the mouth of the Thames estuary at high tide. This means that the volume of water moving upriver will be massively amplified.
Don't underestimate the barrier. It's designed specifically for problems like this.
Not this much water. Sam, you know, I wouldn't come here.
Have you spoken with any of your old colleagues at the Environment Agency about this?
They're not taking my calls.
You're saying the confluence of storm surge and tide
could be catastrophic.
This doesn't make any sense. It was heading east towards Holland 2 hours ago. This wasn't meant to happen. It's heading straight for us.
Commissioner Nash.
Sam Morrison.
Hi, Sam. What can I do for you?
We may have a problem.
I've got Leonard Morrison here. He's an expert in the field.
Professor Morrison has uncovered some worrying data. According to this, it looks as though
the storm and today's spring tide could collide, resulting in a volume of water so great that it could override the barrier. Info. Let me get right back to you.
Of course.
Thank you.
Morrison's an environmental scientist. He was chief analyst at the Flood Hazard Research Centre and sat on a parliamentary advisory committee which reported on the sighting of the barrier. The report he submitted outlined a key flaw. He reckoned that the barrier was situated in the wrong place and recommended that it be built closer to the mouth of the Thames estuary, closer to the sea. Basically, his concern centred around the fact that under certain tidal conditions, the barrier could be overwhelmed.
Get me Sam Morrison again.
He just turned up. He's here about the barrier.
Yeah, of course he is.
Look, I know that this is really bad timing, but I do think we need to listen to what your father has to say.
I don't care what he has to say.
If this storm changes direction...
Is that what this is about? No, don't tell me. Storm surge coincides with the spring tide and the barrier won't hold, am I right?
Yeah. I've seen the forecasting on his model. It's a very real possibility.
I don't believe this. You still don't get it, do you? This is an obsession. This obsession destroyed our lives. He's wrong, but he could never admit it. Even if that meant losing his own family. My mother died, heartbroken because of this. Why should I listen to him now?
Just hear your father out.
I knew Hopkins. What's the latest position?
The storm has dramatically altered its course within the last hour. It's likely to hit the southeastern coast of England later this afternoon.
Can you be more specific?
Well, we're looking at gales of up to 80 miles an hour, so I think we should anticipate considerable damage.
You're all missing the point.
With respect, Professor Morrison, this is hardly an appropriate forum for your theories.
According to my computer model...
Oh, please, must we?
Well, forecasts from the Met Office and the Environment Agency haven't been very accurate so far, have they? Sorry, Professor, please continue.
Assuming no change in wind conditions, my figures indicate that this storm and the tidal surge travelling with it will reach southeast England and the
Thames estuary at high tide.
What does that mean?
The combined volume of water will overwhelm the Thames barrier.
So, are you saying that central London is now at risk?
I'm afraid I am.
And I'm not talking here about a single wave. This is an event that could last for hours.
So which areas are most at risk?
The danger zone includes the Docklands Light Railways, 68 underground stations, 3 World Heritage sites at risk, 8 power stations, dozens of museums, and of course...
Your location in Whitehall.
What does this mean in terms of population?
Approximately 1.5 million people either live or work within the flood danger zone.
How long have we got?
Figures I've received from the Met Office indicate
that the storm will reach the Thames estuary 3 hours from now.
Dear God, that's 7 o'clock this evening. Why didn't anyone see this coming?
Well, somebody did.
We need to initiate evacuation protocol immediately. The longer we delay the decision to evacuate, the greater the risk of there being substantial casualties. Sir?
Do it.
Rob, thanks for in there.
Well, looks like you were right. I'm sorry I didn't believe you. In fact, I'm sorry about a lot of things.
Left unattended, they will be removed and destroyed.
Oh, it takes years to practice, Paul. Yeah.
Yeah, you know, you should maybe be on telly at the same rate.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Hi, Kate. Now, listen, I want you to do something for me. Now, don't ask questions, just listen. Get in the car, take the family, and get as far away from London as you can. I want you to drive as fast as you possibly can. No, no, look, Dad's here with me at the barrier. Don't ask questions, just do what I'm saying. Kate, listen. Dad was right all along. Yeah. Goodbye.
The girls from there. They should be leaving the cinema about now. Penny, make sure you call home too.
Mom.
It was my understanding the emergency services would receive at least 12 hours clear warning of a major flood alert.
And we've had barely three. What the hell have you people been doing?
When this gets out, there's going to be panic on an unprecedented scale. We have less than 3 hours before the surge hits the barrier. How long can we keep the underground running?
We'll have to clear the lines an hour before the water hits.
But that only gives us 2 hours.
Less. To clear the tunnels by 6:20, London Underground are going to have to start withdrawing services around 5 o'clock.
Impossible. That's barely an hour from now. Rush hour will have already started.
Look, trains have to be run out to depots. Staff pulls, stations closed. Fewer trains means we're shifting fewer passengers. Once word gets out, stations will fill with people trying to get out of London. Trains that do manage to get through are going to be full before they even reach most platforms.
Right. I'm declaring a state of emergency.
This just in. The Emergency Management Committee, Cobra.
South. The River Thames are to be evacuated.
Official to the City of London.
Government advice urges those who are able to access exit routes.
Ground wherever possible.
Got to change the circuit.
Initiate the gate closure now.
Right away, Sam.
Yes, ma'am.
Come on, Bill, where are you?
I have to brief the Prime Minister, so I need a status update.
The barrier has initiated closure and evacuation procedures have been activated. Sir, no population movement on this scale in this time frame has ever been attempted. We're dealing with millions of people.
Between the gate and the sills, reduced to 75 millimeters. We're right on target.
I couldn't get through to Kate.
I've spoken to her, so I. Sam, we have to get these people out of here. Time's moving on.
You know, Frank and the boys are refusing to go. I'm not going to leave without them.
Get out of here.
Please evacuate and make your way to the nearest emergency exit.
It's going to be at least 45 minutes
before all schools at risk in the zone have been cleared. That means we may not get to the Queen Elizabeth Hospital in time. The patient population there, approximately 2,000.
This came in a few moments ago, Mark. The Suffolk coast, half an hour ago.
Prioritize the schools.
Bloody hell, it's a proper mission getting down here, isn't it?
Yeah, nearly there.
Right. Up you go, then.
Why I gotta go up?
I'm too fat.
Sweet, sweet, Bill. You do work here, don't you? Filthy up here, Bill.
I know.
Boss, you've got to look at these tidal gauge figures.
Excuse me. Put me through to Commissioner Nash at Cobra.
Hello, Sam?
Ma'am, we've just received some new information.
The search is growing in size and is traveling up the estuary at a height of 4 to 6 meters.
How long have we got?
It's a matter of minutes before it hits us.
Sam, patch all video feeds from the barrier through to us immediately. Girls?
I left messages on their phones with all the numbers here. They'll be patched through to you as a matter of priority the moment they call.
Get me an update on the hospital and school situation as soon as you can.
Mom?
Hey, hear that?
No, I don't hear anything, mate.
Exactly. Hello, Control. Come in, Control. We need to get to a phone. Find out what's going on.
I need to see what's happening out there. Come on. I need pictures. Come on. We gotta get onto the pulpit. Supposed to be instant plug and play.
We're almost there, Mom.
We've got it. Sir?
Jesus.
Can you get in any closer than that?
My God, who's that?
Switch to night vision. It's Professor Morrison. We need that man here. ASAP.
Let's get him here.
Deputy Prime Minister, all military aircraft are committed elsewhere.
Well, then requisition a civilian one. Top priority.
Yes, ma'am.
No. Morrison, what's happening? I want that barrier signal back up. We need to see what's happening out there.
So we've got it.
Good. Mom, Mom, you need to see this.
Recovery 2, search and rescue 4. I think we found your spray.
Denny, here you go.
Recovery 2, search and rescue 4. We're on the way.
Wait, Luke, tell him to wait. There are two more people down there. No, but please, my son's down there. He jumped. You've got to try and find him.
No one could have survived that. I'm sorry.
Figures from Tilbury to London Bridge.
Commissioner, how do we stand at the moment?
Well, sir, we're up against it. The scale of this thing, it's... Even New Orleans can't compare.
Sir, will you stop by this?
What?
I'm really concerned about the security situation. Now, signing this will give the military certain powers, limited powers, to overrule civil authorities during this current state of emergency.
What?
I must retain the authority to coordinate air rescue. I need to get thousands of civilians to safety points, and I can't do that without military assistance. All transport, all vehicles, must remain under Cobra's command.
We're more than willing to work with Cobra, Mom, but I have to ensure the security of all rescue personnel, buildings, government properties.
Of course.
With respect, everything, including security concerns, must remain under the control of Cobra. And Commissioner Nash is to be given full military cooperation in accordance with agreed protocol.
I'm not trying to change procedure, sir. But if civilian unrest does get out of hand, I have to be able to react accordingly.
Yes, but cooperation is what's needed if we're to save lives. And you'll work under Cobra in all areas of the evacuation, reporting to Commissioner Nash. Is that agreed, Major General?
Yes, sir.
Where's my liaison officer?
Behind you, ma'am.
This is the old transformer for the Northern Line.
Well, that's not right. Climb to the top of here, see if we can't get out that way.
Oh, ladder. Here's a pattern for me here, Bill. You know what?
Come on. I think
you might be one of them workplace bullies.
Not now, mate.
You might want to see someone about that.
OK, come on.
No, it's locked. You know, I am having serious second thoughts about all this. Young lad like me, stuck underground with a bloke like you.
Mom?
What?
It seems the girls left you a message early. In the confusion, we didn't get it.
They're meeting friends in town after the film. In town? They could be anywhere.
I'll keep trying to get through to them.
Claire, it's me. This is officially my 100th message. Just give me a call, darling, whenever you can.
The door.
We have to shut down the gas and electricity mains in Deptford, Kennington, Camberwell and Bermondsey.
The hospitals can only run so long on backup jennies, and we're a long way from having them all evacuated.
It's that, or we could have another Fire of London on our hands.
Back figures.
Status report on the royal family.
They've been safely moved to Balmoral.
All right, bullet points, please. We need to look at the time scale we're working to.
Mum, there's no sign of a slowdown. The momentum of the surge itself is enough to keep the water coming, but there's no let up in the wind and the rain. That's just adding to the problem.
The Met storm forecast let us down completely. Is this data reliable?
An event on this scale is practically unheard of. This is a 1,000-year storm. This latest data feed is as accurate as can be.
Yeah, but I need to know what further collateral damage we can expect.
If the surge maintains its current momentum, we have, I don't know, an hour before most of central London is underwater. Two at most.
What can be achieved in 2 hours?
No matter how fast we work, we're not going to get everyone out. So we should concentrate our efforts on the key evacuation areas in the southwest. We should deploy the bulk of our troops and any available emergency service personnel here. Agreed?
But we'll be abandoning this entire corridor of people in the southeast, Bermondsey, Lewisham.
Given the speed this thing moving, we have no choice. We have to prioritize.
Focus on the southwest, Mr. Bourne.
Right. Next scheduled briefing, 15 minutes.
The next press conference is scheduled for...
Just move it to later.
Sounds like they've got a train's running again.
Not no train I've ever heard.
What is it? Is that from the Thames? What is it?
I don't know. We gotta go.
Oh, Bill, mate, what is it? You're freaking me out.
Into one of the worst natural disasters ever recorded. More than 200,000 people are still unaccounted for, and emergency services are stretched to breaking point. The scale of the disaster is...
Professor, are you all right? Patricia Nash.
Why have you brought me here?
We need your help, sir.
My help? I need to find my son.
There's not much you can do for him out there. The best chance to help him is to help us. Your barrier breach model. We need access to it. And your projections for collateral damage in the floodplains.
They may not be relevant anymore.
Of course they're relevant. There are millions of lives still at risk.
I need access to my database on the university server, if it's still up and running.
Is there anything else we can get you, Professor?
I need to find my son, Rob. He's the best marine engineer in the country. His company is under contract to the barriers. Samantha Morris...
He's in charge of barrier operations, yes, sir.
I think he'd head for Defiant.
Defiant?
Defiant Engineering, Rob's company. It's not far from the barrier, but it's on higher ground. There's just a chance they might...
If there's a chance, we'll find them.
Commissioner, this may all be too late.
But we have to try.
If you don't move, you're going to die! Quickly! Come this way! Quickly!
Okay.
Haste. Somebody's coming.
Mind yourself, then.
They work.
Maybe they'll help us.
You okay?
Yeah. It's blocked.
I don't know.
Try.
I'll go and have a look.
Okay.
I'm having a look up there.
Sam, wait up.
Fast service guys have scoffed all the biscuits as usual, so I bought you these. Tea, coffee. They're damn smart girls, Mum.
Just one variable can throw off an entire forecast.
Keith.
Worst storm in our history and I got it wrong.
Keith, don't torture yourself. We all got it wrong.
People make mistakes every day, but mine's going to cost lives. There'll be thousands of them.
You mustn't do this to yourself. No one could have predicted this. Nobody. We've got to keep it together. We've got to do what we can now.
All right.
Look,
I think I've got a bit of a plan. If memory serves me, about 150 metres down there on the other side, there's an air shaft. If it's not flooded, we could perhaps get to ground level that way.
During the blitz, hundreds of people have come down and used these tunnels as shelters, yeah? Government put up these massive steel blast doors, closed them in, sealed them in from the explosives, right? There's got to be one for this station. They're under something official, like a tube map or something. If we can find it, get it closed, could buy us enough time to get that air shaft and get out, yeah?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah?
All right.
Must be what Bill's talking about. Where's Bill?
Read it back to me.
Commissioner Nash, the latest indications are that the storm has turned. It's moving away, heading south.
That's not the point.
Crucial issue is when will the surge lose momentum?
That's what I'm saying. No storm, no surge.
But a surge this powerful will maintain its own momentum and for a long time.
What do you mean?
It could take out the rest of the city.
Are you saying we haven't seen the worst of it?
All of those people at the safety points, including your rescue teams, are at high risk.
Do you see that, Mr. Hopkins? That's just two people. There are countless others depending for their next breath on the accuracy of your forecast, as are we. Keith.
You're gonna have to climb. You're only safe here for 5 minutes at best.
You don't think I can do this?
You can do this.
You're gonna be fine. You will follow me and you're gonna be fine, okay?
What?
This is crazy. If one of us slip.
By my calculations, the water will be 6 to 8 feet deep here, but only 1 or 2 feet deep here. So these are the roads your people should be using to get survivors to Greenwich Park and other safety points.
So these are our key evacuation corridors?
But if these are our only access routes, land-based search and rescue in these other areas is going to be well nigh impossible. I need more air support.
Well, our air support is already deployed. Our pilots are massively overstretched. They're already flying longer than is safe or legal.
My guys aren't overstretched. You can't expect miracles from us if this is all we've got to work with. Would you excuse me a moment?
Got a line.
Repeat that. Yes, that's right. Put them straight through. We want to talk to them. Mom, I think you'll want to take this call.
Is it Claire and Emma?
Claire? I'm sorry. Yes, it's fantastic news. Hang on one second, there's someone here you should be talking to. I'll pass you over. It's for you.
Morrison, yeah?
Dad, it's you.
Rob. Oh, thank God. Rob.
Dad, I thought you were...
I'm still here. I just can't believe it's you. Where are you?
In central London.
What's left of it? We? Is Sam with you?
Yeah.
And she's here.
Rob, I may need your help.
Stay where you are. They'll be able to trace this call. Yeah, I make sure you're both picked up as soon as possible. I can't tell you how relieved I am.
Me too. Rob, I need to speak to Sam. Can you put her on?
Yeah.
Leonard! Oh, God, it's so good to hear your voice.
Listen, Sam, about the barrier.
What?
Do you think it's still operational?
Oh, God, well, I can't imagine the barrier's in very good shape.
Is there any way we could open the gates manually?
Well, yeah. No, you could override the auto setup. But I think access would be an issue.
Sam, I think the barrier is our answer.
What's the problem?
But we need to rendezvous at Defiant first.
Okay.
Although the surge is still ploughing its way upriver, if we lower the barrier, the water upriver can drain into the estuary. What we then need is a force which, in effect, increases the rate at which the tide ebbs.
Is that something we could actually create?
There may be a way. To stop the surge, I think we should open these sluice gates. Let the whole lot flush downstream. We'll need exact timings from the Met Office, of course, so that the whole operation coincides with the ebbing of the tide.
But if we open the sluice gates, wouldn't we just be releasing even more water into the floodplain?
Of course, but if we get the timing right, with the barrier open, we'll have the water from the sluice gates counteracting the surge and the outgoing tide pulling it back down the estuary.
Hopkins? Where the hell's Hopkins? I need him here. Get me the waterways manager. It's Commissioner Nash.
We're gonna go now. I want you to stay and look after the others. Okay? You'll be safe here. Someone will come soon. All right?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Safety points are filling up. We're running out of fresh drinking water. We're going to need to requisition more transport within the next 30 minutes.
Right, but make sure you coordinate with Ashcroft. Oh, I'm due to speak to the PM shortly. Do we know yet how many people didn't get out?
Latest estimate is 200,000, sir. What about him?
His body's just been found.
What? How could...
I should have seen this coming.
Oh, no.
I'm sorry.
Thank you.
So we ask for your understanding and prayers for those who are braving terrible conditions in a bid to save lives. This is just the start of a terrible day of reckoning for London.
Rescue services are under time restraint. And we have to face the consequences.
They're preparing us for the worst.
Loss of life on this scale is
something we've never experienced before in this city. I believe London will survive, and we will recover.
Thank you.
I don't think anyone made it. Not even going to be out looking for us.
May I join you?
Our only reason for being here is to save lives. And God knows how many we lost out there. Failed. Or I did.
You've done everything humanly possible. Countless people owe their lives to you, including me.
Seen the pictures? Who could survive that? My girls are out there. I don't even know where they are.
This all looks great, but in real life, we're dealing with massive, unpredictable forces.
I don't care what your model says. There's no way we can gauge or predict what's going to happen when these two bodies of water come together. It's a hell of a risk, Mom. And the chances of it working out the way the Professor thinks it will must be a million to one.
Leonard?
I've taken all known variables into consideration, including the issue of timing. I think my plan will work.
Blind faith in computer models is what got us into this mess in the first place.
Ignoring computer models.
Please, what are the timing issues?
Low tide at the barrier is 10:45 a.m. For this to work, we have to open the sluice gates at precisely 9:15.
The barrier gates will have to be lowered before the sluice gate waters reach them.
Barrier is not currently operational, as you well know, Professor.
Yeah, indeed, but I've spoken with Samantha Morrison. There is a way of lowering the barrier, but we don't have much time.
If the barrier gates can't be lowered, then the plan with the sluice gates won't work. We'd be gambling with millions of lives.
So you're asking me to open the sluice gates, unleashing millions of gallons of water before we know for sure whether we can lower the barrier. How sure are you?
I'm sending my son and daughter-in-law to the barrier. Does that answer your question?
I need to brief the DPM before we do this. Richardson.
Mark.
How's it going?
All set. Anyway. Kind of, don't want us to be apart anymore.
Let's go.
Messages and rooftops like this one here at Canary Wharf are starting.
This outlines manpower for key positions on the sluice gate.
We're still in the flood zone when the Thames breached its banks. And just when we thought that no one could have survived, thousands of people are holding up signs telling us they're alive. Tens of thousands of people still don't know where they'll be sleeping tonight. But at least for now, London can breathe a sigh of relief as the monster surge that overwhelmed the city literally begins to drain away.
Sir, I need the go-ahead. We're running out of time.
Well, I've already spoken to the Prime Minister about it. But I need to know, is this our only option?
I'm afraid so. Oh, we do nothing, and I'm sure you'll agree that is not an option. There's no guarantee that it will work, Minister, but this is our only hope.
But the key thing is that we...
So, we need a decision.
With a high risk of failure, sir, we cannot take this action.
Sir, we're out of options. We need to do this.
Minister, I'll go to the barrier myself.
Go ahead.
Been picked up by a mobile search and rescue unit. They're safe. Oh.
Thank you. Where's my kids?
They're all that matter.
See you, Dad.
Commander Bryan, if we don't open the barrier in time, our ability to manage this disaster will be non-existent. Within 2 hours, this control center will be taken out.
I understand, Mom.
Give me Professor Morrison.
Certainly, Mom.
Commissioner?
Professor Morrison, the surge is moving further inland.
Are you absolutely sure?
It shows no sign of stopping.
Has Fuller downloaded the latest projections?
Yes.
We're counting on you, Leonard.
Understood.
What we're trying to do is very dangerous.
I'll take the risk, Dad. No one knows the barrier like me. It's my job. I won't let anyone else take my place.
Rob, I know I haven't been much of a father.
Dad, don't.
I wasn't much of a husband
either. Dad, it's obvious now why the work meant so much. I'm sorry I doubted you.
This is where we are, in the backup control room. This is the room we need to get to. It houses the manual override, which will allow us to drain the latch room. The problem is that this room will be flooded, and there's a good chance that all these access routes are also underwater.
So what are you suggesting? All the sluice gates upriver have been opened. We're on a clock here.
We need to drain the latch room in order to operate the hydraulics that will open the barrier. Now, even if we do make it as far as the override room, the barrier's anti-terrorist motives will activate, and there will be no way back out. The drainage system is only operable when the room is sealed from the inside. Whoever goes into this room is going to run out of air before the door can be reopened from the other side. This is a death sentence.
This is madness. We need a contingency if they don't succeed.
What do you suggest?
There is only one option, Mom. The barrier gates must be destroyed.
We don't have the authority.
I'll get it.
Whatever happens on this barrier is my responsibility. I have to.
Sam, listen.
This is no longer a civilian responsibility. As senior officer here, it's my duty. I need you both here to operate the latch release. I've made my decision.
You're a brave man, but we both know it can't be you. You don't know this barrier well enough. It makes sense. Sam, listen.
No, I won't. Why?
You know why. He doesn't know enough to go down there.
Rob, I'm asking you.
It's our only choice.
Minister, all our aircraft are fully armed and fueled. I must reiterate, time is of the essence.
I don't need to be reminded of that, Major General. What is the status of the rescue operation at the barrier?
Well, that's difficult to tell at the moment. We're still having communication problems with the team on the ground.
It's all we need right now.
I don't want our handling of this crisis to come under any more question.
We are monitoring it minute by minute.
Major General, your aircraft are to remain on the ground at the present time.
Deputy Prime Minister, give me a reason to delay this.
Thank you.
Commissioner, Prime Minister for you.
Prime Minister.
Commissioner, I need an update.
The surge waters are continuing to work their way upstream. Their momentum has slowed, but we have major damage and further potential loss of life at Chelsea, Clapham, Hammersmith, and Putney.
And the sluice gate waters that have been released to combat this surge?
Current estimates suggest a confluence between the sluice gate waters and the surge in less than 30 minutes.
It's not enough, Commissioner. You're giving me very few options.
Mum, Commander Bryant's on the line from the barrier.
Good.
Signal's a bit patchy there.
Commissioner Nash,
are you receiving me?
Yes, yes. We're under pressure from the Prime Minister and the military. Unless you can give me something concrete, we have less than 10 minutes before aircraft are ordered to take off and destroy the barrier.
Mum, Professor Morrison is currently trying to engage the manual override system. He may need more than 10 minutes.
I need an exact time.
I can't be more precise.
You don't know when he'll be back?
Buy me all the time you can, Mom. Professor Morrison won't be coming back.
I'm through to the barrier.
They only have to prime the gate before it can open.
Prime Minister, we need to get
the aircraft to the barrier now.
We're running out of time.
Good God.
Prime Minister, we need a decision.
Major General, you have my authority to destroy the barrier.
We have a go. You're clear for takeoff.
We're clear for takeoff.
Sam, you all have to get out of there. Now.
It's too late, ma'am. We're gonna finish this.
Come on. It's only a matter of minutes, Mom.
Follow me.
Commissioner Nash, status report.
You just bear with me a few moments, Prime Minister.
Barrier.
Sam.
The gates are opening. They've done it. They've done it. The gates are opening.
Stand them down, Ashcroft. Abort.
I repeat, abort.
Disengage!